knows the true age of these shrines? The people who built them have long been forgotten, but their work still remains. Watching over the forest like ancient guardians, Taro's spirit has corrupted the shrines and sealed the entrance to the Guardian Tree. I can feel Taro's presence there. I marked the shrine locations on your map.
Thank you, Uruzu. I'll work to clean the shrines.
Thank you.
move that for me?
Right there.
Yeah.
Over there. Heal. Right there. Hi. Over there. Right there.
The Guardian Tree was burnt out by fire, but it lives on. Its roots run deep, connecting it with the ancient shrines. Clean the shrines, and the door will open.
See that over there? Over there. Yeah.
the shrines represent guardians of the forest from up here. It's easy to imagine them watching over the land.
There are several worn fishing baskets here. A simple design, but effective.
Thank you.
get that.
This leads to the Lantern Cave. A relic must be there. But we'll need something powerful to break through.
Go.
Thank you.
bro, really?
Go get it.
Right there.
No matter what, how you make trouble off of it.
Children in Taro often fished in these streams. In the stillness of the forest, I can almost hear their voices.
Taro and his siblings felt safe in these woods. You taught them well, Ruthu.
guardian tree, asking it to protect the ones we love. Taro left this for the children. He must have been so scared when he lost them. Many of the offerings here were placed by the first village leaders. Skilled hunters who use spirit energy to create powerful weapons. I'm sure the guardian tree won't mind if we use them to help Taro. I don't know what corruption waits for you in the Lantern Cave, but I suspect Taro's spirit will fight to the end.
stop and move. Yeah.
Yeah.
Unless you skim through my knees, I guess. Can you set the size certain?
A fox symbol is marked on this old camping gear.
Thank you.
Right there.
Taro's lantern. He must have lost it searching for the children.
Bring the relics to the fallen tree. It's time to help Taro find peace.
Mm-hmm. the sickness that took our parents was spreading through the village.
Spirits of the forest, walk with our people. Guide them on their journey to the mountain shrine.
Food was running low. Everyone was scared. I never felt so helpless. Saya wanted to stay, but I thought we could go to Rusu for help. I was sure he would know what to do. But something was not right in the woods. I had never seen Rusu so worried. He sent us back to the village. And I knew we were alone. I was all that Benny and Saya had left. I had to protect them. Happened the next morning. The explosion from the mountain shrine covered the land in darkness. For days. I searched everywhere for them. I was their older brother. I was supposed to protect them. Even now, hard to forgive myself.
Taro, the children know how much you care for them. What happened in the village wasn't your fault. You will always be their older brother, and they still need you.
Shrine.
It's okay. You have to go now.
Taro rests with his siblings now. I imagine the corruption in the forest has cleared as well.
I know it was time for Benny and Saya to move on with their brother, but the forest won't be the same without them.
It's natural to build a connection with the spirits we have. We give up a part of ourselves, but they move on. The bond still remains. The path of a spirit guide is a lonely one. There is still work to be done if you wish to reach the mountain shrine. A skilled woodsmith once lived in our village and built structures beyond anyone's imagination. Search the fields beyond the storehouse for her troubled spirit.